magical nobles.
Back again, Lord Rosfield. I'm touched that you should find me such good company.
It is not your company, but your counsel that I seek on this occasion.
Ever the charmer. What will it be today, then?
The Iron Kingdom. I need to know what to expect.
You'll soon be setting sail for Drake's Breath, then, I take it. The Mother Crystal that rises from the boiling sea. There was a time when a true-blooded Rosarian had only to brave the waves to visit it. But then the Ironblood made their move. As you know, the Iron Kingdom rules over the islands to the west of Storm. Or rather, its church does. But this is not the pragmatic approach to state religion employed by the Holy Empire to manipulate the masses. No. The Iron Kingdom is the literal embodiment of the crystalline orthodoxy. And so, if one is to understand it, one must start there. As the name implies, the orthodoxy holds the Mother Crystal sacred, and they do not take kindly to heathens plundering the objects of their worship for the means to fill washtubs and light lamps with frivolous feats of magic. Indeed, the faithful consider ether a sinful thing, a poison no less. And to them, a dominant is an instrument of evil, albeit one they have proven only too happy to turn against their enemies. Some 80 years ago, in Northern Storm, Drake's Eye collapsed. Soon after, in pursuit of ether and with the Blight at their backs, the Northern Territories descended upon the Grand Duchy of Rosaria. And when the Shields of the Flame marched north to meet them, the Iron Kingdom spied an opportunity. A few short days later, the Crusaders landed on the island of Mount Drastanus, home of Drake's Breath, and plucked it from the Duchy's grasp. Rosaria tried to reclaim it, of course, but to no avail. I doubt more than a handful of Duchy men have set foot on its shores in your lifetime. Nor are they like to again, under the Empire's stewardship. Meaning the Iron Blood will keep their island. And with it, the foothold they need to march on mainland soil when next they spy an opportunity. The Mother Crystal is both the object of the Iron Blood's worship and their gateway to the continent, making Drastanus the holiest of holy grounds, from which the Orthodox Crusade shall one day sail forth to claim the remaining Mother Crystals, or die trying.
My father and my grandfather both traded blows with the Iron Blood for control of Drake's Breath. Had things unfolded differently at Phoenix Gate, we would have sent our entire fleet against them.
But instead, they sent their fleet against Rosaria, sacked the capital, killed the men, and captured the women, including Jill. I'd say you'd be forgiven for wanting a little revenge, Clive.
My only aim is to destroy the Mother Crystal. But thank you all the same. Not much else to do here. Let's see if Jill's ready.
It will be over soon. One way or another.
You ready?
I think so.
Jill, when you told me you had to come to terms with your past, you weren't talking about destroying Drake's Breath, were you?
No. I spoke of Imran, the leader of the Crystalline Orthodox, the man who made me do all those unspeakable things. I'm going to kill him. It's what I need to do to put the past behind me.
what I need to move forward. And I know that I can do it. If you're there beside me.
Always.
And I'll be beside you, too. We'll bring down the Mother Crystal together. All while Cid looks on.
We'll make him proud.
Useful trick. Freezing and thawing the spray to make mist. How did you learn to use your powers like this?
The Masters made me do it. When the Crusaders took to the seas. To keep the fleet's movements from prying eyes. I'm fine.
No, you're not.
This may be the only chance I get to go back. My only chance to put things right. I have to do this. Whatever the cost.
All right.
She is. The Iron Kingdom's Mother Crystal.
Drake's breath. Strong currents, sharp rocks, and ether floods. Let's not forget them. This island is a natural fortress.
But safety breeds complacency, allowing a single rowing boat to slip in unseen. The sanctuary is inside the mountain. If we follow the old trail, we should be able to enter by the back gate.
All right. Let's go.
I always imagined when I came here it would be to reclaim it.
It used to belong to Rosaria, didn't it?
Once, though it's been in the Ironblood's clutches for far too long.
As was I. For 13 years, this rock was my home. I know its secrets only too well. This path was abandoned after an ether flood. They don't guard it anymore.
The perfect little shortcut. They're all Akashic.
These blood must have spread. It was never as bad as this before. Then the only way past them is through them.
Nothing to worry about.
Look at this place. What a mess.
Wait.
press on?
Yes. It's like a furnace in here.
We're inside the volcano. You get used to the heat. Though I don't remember it being quite this hot.
Was that one cause for concern?
It was. And they're getting bigger. Something's wrong. Do that again.
No, let's not. They don't look too tough.
Perhaps not alone, but in numbers like these.
Ugh!
absolutely no idea.
Well, whatever it is, I don't think it's friendly. Too slow.
Leave the lava.
If I didn't know better, I think this volcano was about to erupt.
Why attack us then? They're peaceful creatures.
Then this one must be the exception.
Thank you.
Just hot. Thank you.
Quite a commotion our friend made. Let's hope the guards didn't hear it.
The gate to the inner chambers is just up there. Then we make for the sanctuary. I need to finish this before the heat finishes me.
Hear, hear.
We'll enter the Comrick by the Handmaiden's living quarters. It was always a hive of activity.
Sounds like we'll have a hard time staying out of sight.
We won't have to. There's someone there I should very much like to see.